ist dem Feind gelungen, die Front in breiter Formation zu durchbrechen. Im Süden hat der Gegner Zossen genommen und stößt auf Stahnsdorf vor. Der Feind operiert jetzt am nördlichen Stadtrand zwischen Frohnau und Pankow. Und im Osten ist der Feind bis zur Linie Lichtenberg-Mahlsdorf-Karlshorst gelangt.
Mit dem Angriff Steiners wird das alles in Ordnung kommen.
Mein Führer, Steiner...
Steiner konnte nicht genügend Kräfte für einen Angriff massieren. Der Angriff Steiner ist nicht erfolgt.
Es bleiben im Raum Keitel, Jodl, Krebs und Burgdorf. Das war ein Befehl! Der Angriff Steiners war ein Befehl! Wer schickt Sie?
Das hier ist Wagen! Sie mein Befehl zu Ihrer Seite! Das einfach gekommen. Das Militär hat mich verlogen!
Jeder hat mich verlogen, sogar die SS! Die gesamte Generalität ist nichts weiter als ein Haufen niederträchtiger, treuloser Feiglinge!
Mein Führer, ich kann nicht zulassen, dass die Soldaten, die für Sie verbringen...
Nicht als Feiglinge! Verräter, Versager!
Mein Führer, was Sie da sagen, ist ungeheuerlich!
Die Generalität ist das Geschmeiß des deutschen Volkes! Sie ist ohne Ehre! Sie nennen sich Generale, weil Sie Jahre auf Militärakademien zugebracht haben, nur um zu lernen, wie man Messer und Gabel hält.
Jahrelang hat das Militär meine Aktionen nur behindert. Es hat mich jeden nur als
Widerstand in den Weg gelegt. Ich hätte gut daran getan, von Jahren alle höheren Offiziere registrieren zu lassen, wie Stalin. Ich war nie auf einer Akademie. Und doch habe ich allein auf mich gestellt, ganz Europa erobert. Verräter! Von allem Anfang an bin ich so verraten und betrogen worden. Es wurde ein ungeheurer Verrat geübt am deutschen Volke. Aber alle diese Verräter werden bezahlen. Mit ihrem eigenen Blut werden sie bezahlen. Sie werden saufen in ihrem eigenen Blut.
Bitte, Gerda, jetzt beruhig dich doch.
Meine Befehle sind in den Wind gesprochen. Es ist unmöglich, unter diesen Umständen zu führen. Es ist aus.
Der Krieg ist verloren. Aber wenn Sie, meine Herren, glauben, dass ich deswegen Berlin verlasse, irren Sie sich gewaltig. Eher jage ich mir eine Kugel durch den Kopf. Tun Sie, was Sie wollen.
Congratulations, Fairy Odd Parents. I honestly didn't even think a modern cartoon episode can top what you did. I don't even know anymore. I really want to start the review just to get it over with, but then I don't even want to touch this. It's trash. It's animated trash. Guess how many writers they needed to write this trash? Four. Four people went to college and paid tuition just to write this. Go ahead and hate Breadwinners, Teen Titans Go, or Pickle and Peanut. Go ahead and hate them with all your might. At least they have a purpose and execute it. Breadwinners wanted to capitalize on video game references and cheap flash animation. Pickle and Peanut wanted to be ironically uncool, being a poor man's regular show. Teen Titans Go wanted to be a cheap comedy out of a well-respected franchise. What does Fairy Odd Parents and its 10th season want to say? What plots does it have that needed to be done? Why does this show need to air? I legit don't know, except for milking the franchise and ad revenue. Nickelodeon, We once had Fairy Odd Parents be that cartoon. It surpassed SpongeBob, and it continued knocking each episode out of the park. Even with Tough Puppy, you have Sanjay and Craig and Rocket Monkeys that makes a mockery out of professional animation. I understand where Loud House, Harvey Beaks, and Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles can shine, but none of it matters if Nickelodeon doesn't support it and future cartoons like it. They bump everything not SpongeBob and Fairy Odd Parents down to Nicktoons, something that not every person who has Nickelodeon has. I said before that the quality of some shows that get demoted, because I'm calling it how it is, increase not having to deal with the crap quota of Nick. Not even sure if I'm being literal or not. You know what really gets me though? I only watched 2 episodes of this crappy season. 2 episodes. This season is 2 for 2 for the worst cartoon episodes to be ever aired. The excuse that they're trying to get off Nickelodeon doesn't even fly with me anymore. This is not effort. This is a 12-minute long try not to rage episode. I watched this episode when it aired months ago. I even talked about it on one of the live streams I did. I watched it again months later and I'm still fuming. And when I talk about bad episodes like The Fourth Wall or Greg, they're bad, but I don't want to do a 35-minute video on that specific episode. To everyone viewing this video, you don't only need to know that this failed, but you need to know in every single way exactly how it failed. And I will not hesitate to show them exactly how and why. So without further ado, let's bring in Girly Squirrely. The show starts off in the forest with Timmy's dad as the scout. He claims to have s'mores and a roaring fire. Obviously, the opposite happens because the show cannot subvert the expectations anymore.
I am on kind of a roll lately.
You get it? It's every single joke about that ever. I also like how the fire is behind the lair. You made no effort to make it appear like the shoe is on fire. From my perspective, the fire is on shoe. So the bus blows up and it blows up everyone. No, but I wish. I really wish.
Enough with the blood curdling scream, Timmy!
Or you can revisit your little furry friends!
Did Tara forget that she's voicing a preteen male? Actually, this was intentional, which makes even less sense. The show has been able to create girlish screams from a guy before. Take Francis, for example. Sometimes his screams get so high in pitch, it comes across as girly, but the cadence is still there, so you can still tell it's him. This is just Tara Strong, or God forbid, a royalty-free stock scream. Either that, or Timmy woke up to a nightmare of Nickelodeon bringing in another character for the next season. Seriously, if another episode is confirmed and another character debuts, Fairy Odd Parents Season 10 or 11 has no right to call itself an original series or continuation. It is a spin-off, and it's the worst one in this decade. So his, not Chloe's fairies, come to his aid, and Cosmo makes a joke about Timmy receiving low grades because Cosmo never did that on an episode revolving 3D. At least if you're gonna do something again, put a spin on it, or else you look like you're not only lazy, but cheap. We get it, okay? You really want Fairy Odd Parents to continue.
But that could never happen, because our lame-o troop was banned by the Squirrely Scout Council!
And then the opposite happens. Take a shot every time I say, and the opposite happens. I would say just down your whole drink, but I actually care for you guys, and I don't want your livers to be as destroyed as this series.
Why? No!
Hey, music directing in the Nickelodeon cartoon isn't hard at all. Just put every single song on shuffle and pray for the best. Trust me, it really works. So Timmy's dad says that he is going to get the Squirrel Scouts back together. Oh, does that mean we'll see AJ and Chester and Sanjay and Elmer? No? That's right, guys. I can confirm. Sparky, Foop, Poof, AJ, Chester, Sanjay, Elmer, Tootie, Vicky, Francis, Principal Waxaplex, Wandissimo, Cupid, Doug Dimmadale, Remy Buxaplenty, the Pixies, and most importantly, Miss Perfect Little Girl's parents are nowhere to be seen in this episode. That is 2 episodes in a row, sans Foop, where a majority of the people you thought were actual characters of the show are thrown to the side for bland character A and side child character B. But you know who makes her second run around? The walking Mary Sue herself, Chloe. I apologize on behalf of anyone in this universe or any other multiple universe dimensions for having their name associated with this excuse for a compelling character. There is making a character to be liked, and making a character that the writers want you to have no choice in liking. Yes, he's the same perfect, but actually pretty darn close to perfect character in their last run on my channel. The only difference is that here, the show made a blatant, insulting, fatal flaw. They made Chloe, the girl that many people still haven't grown to, the focus of the show. Yes, my friends, she does more for the plot than Timmy Turner, Timmy freaking Turner. You know, the guy who originally had fairy godparents because his parents were not the best and Vicky didn't make it any better. What kind of drugs do you need to be on to make the Mary Sue the main protagonist in a professionally made for TV cartoon?
Anywho, all we have to do is earn a single merit badge and Squirrely Scout Troop Lucky 13 is back in business.
Why is Timmy so small next to his dad? In fact, why is Timmy this small in general? Does anyone feel like they're subliminally trying to make a change in Timmy's height? So Timmy's dad introduces them to the camp supervisor, who just so happens to be a bear. So this bear doesn't speak English, mind you, and is the supposed authority. They get their humor from Tough Puppy, which honestly created a downfall for Butch Hartman's cartoons. Random and zany is one thing, but when things happen because you need logic and sense, that is a good episode.
Dad, only a total nutjob would want to go on another Squirrely Scout camping trip!
And then the episode tries to reverse your expectations. Let me explain a bit about explanations. People can only be surprised at something you say if you never say it. Right, Waffles?
Squirrely Scout Chloe Carmichael reporting for duty!
Not only is Chloe super smart and super strong, she's also going to be the ringleader.
Girls aren't allowed to be Squirrely Scouts!
Yes, because they really want to lay it home that the Fairy Odd Parents are trying to make Timmy's dad look foolish and stupid. Also, Chloe is going through adversity. Guess how she deals with this injustice? By wishing it gone. Yes, riveting storytelling. We sure have come far from photos etched on the walls of ancient caves. Also, animation error. We're not even 5 minutes in and I'm just getting started. There's nothing funny within the first 3 minutes. Use the It's Just for Kids argument, because I really can get on that logic. Unless you're into that whole sit down and shut up mentality that should have died off as soon as it started, what part of this is funny? Sure, it isn't discrimination, but it is the world's smallest barrier for this plot to happen. When the show started, even I had the idea in my head that since you have fairies, many plots can be hand-waved with just a wish or two. First of all, they hand-wave it here just insults me on a personal level. Trust me, I don't want to spoil it. And number two, I wouldn't mind so much if they already didn't do an episode where Timmy's mom was shown to be just as, if not already a way better substitute for their particular scouts. Not only that, but how did Chloe already have the uniform? Even the title isn't original. Shut up. Like, really, shut up. So Timmy decides to wish himself away from everyone, but the place he wishes himself to just so happens to be the next place they need to go. What is it with this season and having Timmy wish himself away and just so happens to be the next place where the plot needs him to be? They have this pathetic, just thin piece of string called a plot that they really want to follow.
I wish I was lost with Biscuit. Just my luck, Biscuit was lost in the Squirrely Scout bus.
Is it really? Is it really? Let's skip the song they sing because it involves shaking their butts. And you know what? If you guys are sick of it, then you obviously don't know top-notch humor. I mean, Chloe says that she's ready for duty. You know, which every idiot dad makes the obvious joke, right? Again, it's very jarring how much they're trying to avoid Chester and AJ. I didn't like the real-life adaptation, but as of now, the real-life movies are much better. At least they decided to at least try and follow the cartoon. How in any way does this feel like the original show? And I know, things change. I mean, I'm probably the only reviewer on YouTube defending Pickle and Peanut, defending Fanboy and Chum Chum, and Clarence, because they're comedy shows and they serve a particular crowd. But this is 2016 and this is inexcusable.
Chloe! That's a girl's name because she's a girl!
A girl? I hear if you touch them, they control your brain for life!
I'm sorry, did you think you were in a bus with an attack helicopter? No, the writers feel they need to stuff every cliche in this show. I wouldn't be surprised if they brought in feces jokes.
Okay, who needs to change their pants? Just me?
Terrific. The clouds that shouldn't be there give the campers the reactions they never should really have. The forest that the Squirrely Scouts stay at is called Stinkfoot's National Forest. So you know there's gonna be a mythical beast called Stinkfoot. But don't worry, we have Chloe. I think she's rescued a monster before. How about now? Oh yeah, that's right. She destroyed an entire town.
Sweet dim Ricky, there is no Stinkfoot!
And then the opposite happens. Not even halfway through and I'm still disappointed. Now we get the worst scene in this episode. You know what? Screw Viacom with playing the entire thing. I'm literally gonna grab you by the back of your neck and show you the feces that you've made on this franchise.
I love spending time with Chloe and Timmy, but this place stinks!
Don't worry, Davey, I got an idea!
Oh, look! A bubbling brook! Let's see how deep it is!
What do you know? It's highly corrosive stomach acid!
Where do I begin? First of all, cans. Second of all, exactly why did they stick their wands in acid? You know, other than the nix the reason that Timmy and Chloe to wish themselves out of this situation. Third, according to your logic, when you wish the house was back above ground in the episode involving Sparky for the first time, you had backup wands. So I will never let you forget that. With four writers, the best that they can come up with is that Cosmo, and more disappointingly Wanda, willingly melt their wands out of curiosity. Usually Cosmo gets in trouble and Wanda pays for it in creative ways. Now it seems like no one even cares. This entire episode, it just has this blatant emptiness. No plot, little relatable characters, and now the fairies are kicked to the curb. No, really, they really don't come back for a majority of this episode. I don't understand why they turned into cans just to get swallowed by a bear. You'd think if Wanda really wanted the forest to stop smelling, she'd do, wish it away? It's not like Chloe didn't just wish for the female gender, and yes, I'm getting it right, the female gender to be included in the scouts. They give the bear indigestion, which makes me wonder why that would lead to more acid. The writers never explain. They just put the characters in this situation because situation. An infant wouldn't even be interested in the colors being shown on the screen. But what frustrates me the most is that Wanda did this. Yes, the smart one, or at least, not counting Chloe, the smartest one. She's the one who points out the babbling brook, even though she knew she was inside a bear. She is the one who wants to know how deep this brook is. And she is the one who initiates the wands being burnt. And let's look at it from her logic. Even if this wasn't stomach acid, what else is in your body? Blood or saliva? So either this got really messed up or really gross. Both of which are staples in Nickelodeon humor. Either way you slice it, this is the most pathetic way to make a story. This is just excuses and contrived plots.
Okay, fellow squirrely scouts, gather round! Everyone chill! Time to get that merit badge!
Although Chloe isn't the perfect little angel like in the Big Fairy Share Scare, the fact that her character still has shades of being the most contrived, obnoxious, child insert Mary Sue character in this modern run of cartoons is on nearly unreachable levels of insult. Of course, the scouts are incompetent because wimps. They have a weird sound gag which involves one of the children yelling that they're lost. It sounds like the character is far, which he's not, which only brings me out of their immersion. Even the sound designer gave up on this show. The sound designer.
Focus! If we want the merit badge, we have to climb Mount Stinkfoot!
Let me guess, it looks dangerous, but it's not.
Hey, Timmy, all the troop needed was a little motivation.
And then the opposite happens. Whoa there, let me take a drink from you. You're already drinking too much. I can understand why you wouldn't want to put so much work into this terrible execution. So instead of rock climbing, they try for the white water rafting badge. Everyone cries because they're in a Nickelodeon TV show. I also don't understand why Timmy's dad is in the boat by himself. It's not like one of the other children fell into quicksand earlier. Also, anyone up for a game of guess the error? Error number one, Chloe. No, not really. But how come the other campers fall out the boat but aren't seen in the bird's eye view shot? Error number two, no matter how perfect Chloe is, she is not the leader, so she should not be doing this much. Error number three, how did Timmy and Chloe, the girl who can paddle, fall into the water? Error number four, why would you learn paddling in the most dangerous river? And lastly, error number five, how much looping did you use to cut corners in this episode?
Hey, squirrely scouts!
So why did this kid teleport? In fact, what is he doing? Why does he even look like this in the first place? So much about this episode screams end this show. And coming from a person who had literally a grammar error in his first review of this franchise, you're pathetic. Heck, even Timmy doesn't sound like his normal self. You see how Chloe's the example of a great leader? What is her flaws here? She's perfect, and she wants you to know. Also, they bring back Cosmo and Wanda. Glad to see one of the pair of main characters of this show is not forgotten for new kids that we will most likely never see again. Maybe Cosmo and Wanda walked out of the show and needed to fix their concept.
Can't you just quit like the rest of us? Did you just say the Q word? That is a bad word, Timmy!
This is coming from the same girl who wanted to share everything and backed out of that wish. Yeah, like she doesn't know the word quit. She also read the entire Scout handbook because perfect. She's just so flawless. There is no reason for me to care. Yeah, let's just keep going.
I found a merit badge that anyone can get. Even Chips have done it. Come on, these guys are nowhere near Chip standards.
Then why are you in the Scout Club? Seriously, at least with the Mighty Bee and Camp Lazlo, they at least want to do it. So Chloe suggests a knot tying badge, and of course they can't do it. Look at this. Look at this animation. Look at that waterfall. How many animators did they have? This animation is one of the worst I've seen in this entire series. And this series dates back to the 90s, back when Adobe Flash wasn't a commonplace thing. So we get the scene where they all talk at night, and this just infuriates me. Not as much as the Cosmo and Wanda part, but the fire is still there. First of all, they have Cosmo and Wanda scream help when they're in clear view to leave the mouth. You know the show that built for 9 seasons that Timmy and his godparents are the closest thing in the universe? Timmy sure doesn't acknowledge his fairies at all during this entire camping trip. Also, have you ever heard of the phrase 2-frame animation? The degrading form of using 2 frames back and forth because you don't want to put in effort? Even if your budget is the cost of a cup of coffee, which it's not. People have done better with free animation and time. I really don't want to hear the topic of limited budget. Unless you're doing a Lord of the Rings, or a Jimmy Timmy Power Hour, or a TV movie, not special, or something that requires a lot of work for good reason, then you should have enough to do, even a simple episode like this.
Chloe, I'm inspired by your can-do attitude! Scouts, we can't do this!
Okay, one, if you're inspired by her can-do attitude, then why can't you do it? 2, the bear is smiling even though he's the supervisor? 3, Chloe smiles in this scene, but not in the next one. But in the next one, she's concerned. I know she's supposed to be sad, but an oversight like this is unacceptable, especially from a Mary Sue.
Too bad, Chloe. Looks like everyone's quitting. Yeah, I said it. Quitting.
Are you 100% sure that Timmy is supposed to be the antagonist? This episode is trying to make Chloe the main character. Sure, we have the Donut of Shame from SpongeBob where Patrick was the main character, and the Crass Nebula episode of this series, but both had reasons. The only reason I can think to focus on Chloe is because no one likes her, and we need to bring Timmy down so that Chloe looks better in comparison. The kid who brought us Channel Chasers, Abracatastrophe, the Wishology series, and countless other great episodes shouldn't be compared to the girl who got fairies because reasons.
And I don't get it! Everything about Chloe is perfect! Why does she even need fairies?
There is a reason for everything, Turner, except for fanny packs. Just have the guts to carry a man purse!
This is what the series has come to.
We came here to get those stinking badges, and nobody's leaving until we do! It's right there with the stupid Squirrely Scout song!
If it's stupid, why did you sing it twice? Oh, that's right, because just like the staff of Teen Titans Go, you want to use stupid as a common term, when in reality your show really is stupid. Also, he doesn't care for the song, yet he is the main reason everyone is out here. Why is Chloe the only person who wants to go on this trip? She's not the supervisor, she's not the leader, and she's not Timmy Turner. And yet she's acting like the first two. Was writing credits on this show like a giant sweepstakes that I wasn't a part of, and some kid won it? And is now writing Nickelodeon, and is now writing themselves to look as great as possible? Because I really wouldn't be surprised. Also, let's talk about the art style. It's so watered down that if I traced it in Microsoft Paint, it would look 100 times better. So Chloe gets kidnapped by Monster of the Week, and Timmy's dad says it's a relief. Best line in the show. Then everyone goes home, and the monster rips Chloe to shreds, as an elaborate take that to Mary Sue's. I wish. So with 1 minute left, the climax is running up a hill. Wow. Move aside, Michael Bay. This is the real explosive action. Let's all take notes.
I'm going in! Chloe! I'll save you from...
I hate to play this card, but what were you gonna do, Timmy? Someone, somewhere, tell me, what would Timmy do? Honestly, I think he would want his fairies to himself, so he probably wouldn't save her. But plot. What is Timmy's character here? What is his motivation? His entire role was being the one who failed and complained, just like the rest of them. But now he becomes a hero? Why would he even quote the song he trashed for like 10 straight minutes? So let me not waste any more of your time. Just like the first episode, the monster really isn't harmful, but actually is harmful. So Timmy's dad sent the monster on a rampage.
I got the s'mores and put you all in terrible danger. Run!
Quick question, who's chasing you? In every scene after Timmy's dad takes the s'mores, you never see the monster. I can only guess that towards the end of the episode, they got even more lazy. I didn't even think it was possible, but guys, they got even more lazy. The episode ends with Cosmo and Wanda getting out from no effort on their own, and they leave a kid in the wilderness. Funny, because this isn't the first time they left a kid in the wilderness, if you count live action. So let me get this straight, Nick. Leaving a kid in the wilderness, that's okay. Licking a butt in a thorough manner, that's okay. Duck rape, that's okay. Pregnancy through a fart is okay. But one of the only shows trying to spread a positive message that just so happens to have a character with two dads? Nah, no kid should be exposed to that. If anyone can find a season of an animated series on Nick, Cartoon, or Disney that is airing this year in America that is worse than this one, I will do a dance on Facecam. That is how serious I am. It has to have aired this year on Disney, Cartoon Network, or Nick, and it has to have aired in America. There is no season that has been worse than this. I guarantee it. There's nothing. There really is nothing. There's never been a show in my childhood that has slumped this low. All of them ended or redeemed themselves before they hit this low. And to be honest, I don't want to give this an outro. It sucks, everyone. It sucks. In my opinion, this sucks. And I think everyone who has worked on this should be ashamed for thinking that this is an industry standard cartoon animation. This is coming from a guy who has zero budget, a Blue Yeti mic, and Sony Vegas on a one-man staff team. So thank you all for listening. Thank you guys for 1,000 subscribers and Fairy Odd Parents Season 10. I mean this in the most sincere way. Go to hell. Do you hear these helicopters? Let me turn up the gain. The Viacom people are trying to make sure that I don't record this. The big bad Viacom helicopters are making sure that I don't record this script. They really are. This is like the fourth time they've come around. You know what? I'm just going to keep recording this. This is the fourth time that there's just a giant words, Viacom. They know what I'm about to say is not good. This is how you know something's major. This is exactly how you know something's major. I hit 13K with my first video. They are making sure that I don't capture lightning in a bottle twice. They know. They know. Like, there's a war happening outside. I don't know what's happening outside, but something hit the ground hard. Because they're trying to get whatever they're trying to get, they're not getting it. And I'm trying to, I really can't get it. Like, it keeps going around and around. I can't do anything. Can't record because I don't want to get this recording in it, but you know what? Thank you guys so much for 1,000 subscribers. I really do appreciate it because yeah, guys, I gotta go on my bunker. I'll see you guys later.